Thank you, Jesus. Pastor is shepherd. Amen. Shepherd leads, goes before you. And the sheep hear and then they follow. Amen. Is that true? What happens if you did not? What happens to the sheep that do not follow the shepherd? What happens to those sheep? They stray. Lost. You know, I'm telling some truth to you. I'm telling you some truth. And I'm not here by accident. I'm not your pastor by accident. I'm not here by accident. It's by the calling of the Lord. And this calling could have happened, not could have happened, happened even before I was born. I said sometimes to you, when I was born, probably I would not have been born because my mother was not fit to deliver. She would have died. I would have died in her womb. But because there is calling on my life, God brought me out. But today we are here by God's grace. We all have a past. It's not only me. You all have something to talk like this. You all are alive today and in this place with a calling and a purpose. None of you here are an accident into this world. I hear some parents telling about the children, hey, this guy was an accident. Some people talk like this. Oh, this guy was an accident. We were not expecting him. We were not expecting her. She was an accident. In God's eyes, nothing is an accident. He prepares everything and brings into existence what he has decided to. Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to take to one scripture. 1 Peter. Was it 1 Peter? No. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 10. 2 Peter chapter 1. Verse 10. Thank you, Lord Jesus. This morning, we'll surely understand something and we'll go to a place where God has called us to be. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. You know, this is a command. When it is in the Word of God, whether Peter writes or Paul writes, that is a command. The word in the English language, it says, therefore, brethren, you're all brethren, amen? And sisters will say, are we not included? I always say, in the spirit, we're all brethren. There is no difference of sex in kingdom of God. And I've been seeing some funny things, some videos, and some teachings that are going in this religion that we are, they have very different picture about heaven. For us, Lord Jesus said, you will be like angels in heaven. There is no marriages. There nobody's given into marriage. So there is no nothing of what your husband and wife enjoying today. There's nothing like that in heaven. We are like angels. We'll have joy, peace, enjoying the beauty that God has prepared for all of us from the beginning. That's what is it. But then, here it says, therefore, brethren, be even more diligent, brothers and sisters, together. Diligent to make your call and election sure. You know, I just want to put your heart on that. I want to ask you, how many of you feel that you are called? Do you know that you have a purpose in your life? You think about it sometimes. Do you take some time to sit down and say, what am I on this earth for? Hallelujah. I want everyone to look at me, please. Are you thinking, are you lost? Some you feel that you are lost in the world. God is looking at you right now, wherever you are. He's looking at you. When he said, I have inscribed you in the palm of my hand. Why did he say this word? Because to tell you and me, I am mindful of you. Always, constantly, in the day, in the night, at all times, I am thinking about you. That word in 1 Peter chapter 5, Verse 6 says, cast your cares upon Jesus because he cares for you. And I like that word in my own mother tongue. It says, because he's worrying. The word is used is, let me say, there are some people who understand me. What he says is, God himself is worrying for you. So cast your worries upon God. He's thinking about your needs and your problems. Hallelujah. He's thinking for you. Your condition is known to him. Some of you may be sitting there and thinking, but my condition, does he know? I have been praying for this last 10 years. He did not answer me. My condition, does he know? Last 5 years, I've been asking for this one little thing. He's not been answering my prayer. Some of you thinking like this. Last 10 days, I've been going through this pain. Does he know my condition? Some may be very little. I've been asking one thing. I've been praying for one thing. Does he know my condition? But I want to tell you, by the authority of the Word of God, I believe Word of God, every bit of it, one letter or one dot, is true and there is no doubt about it. When he says he's thinking about you, he's thinking it's for you to take it seriously in your heart. Say, if the word says so, so it is for me and for you. There is no difference. He's thinking, brothers, he's thinking about us. We are alive. Just thinking about those people are perishing every day. What I was taught, I was praying for Chennai. Did they think this kind of rain will come? I was reading, somebody's posted in the one of those things. One man who's doing very well in his job, everything. He says he was expecting to go to his work. Got a very good job, very house, but now he's not able to get out of the house. Now he doesn't have a glass of drinking water in the house for him and for his children. Did he think that's going to happen to him? He has money. I have credit cards, everything is there, but I don't have water to drink. He cannot get out of the house to get that water. It can happen to anybody. But then, when we enjoy the best of the Lord, what he has given to us, we must be thankful. Amen. We have one problem. We always look at our problem and think it's very big, but that brother doesn't have, that sister doesn't have this problem. My problem is so big. But God wants us to understand he cares for us. But then he has a definitive call for us. What does it say in 1 Peter again? 2 Peter 1 verse. Let's go back to that. 2 Peter verse 1, verse 10. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. God has a plan for you. And it is your responsibility to understand what plan he has. There is a definitive call. Many of you may think Pastor Manohar has a call, Pastor Arun has a call to be pastors, but we are having a call to be members in the church so that we can go only once a week to church and sit down there and worship God, give our offerings and go back. That's some of you may be thinking. I want to tell you, that's not what God is talking to us. Every word that has been written in the Bible, in the Word of God, is for all of us. The call is basically, the main and the purpose of this call is, we got to be effective in his kingdom. Are you with me? God's call for you and me is that we must be effective in the kingdom. Okay, let me take you to 1 Peter chapter 2. Chapter 2, verse 9. We all are called. Chapter 2, verse 9. But you are chosen generation. You are chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may... Oh, no, just tell me, are you chosen? Just answer to me, everyone. Are you chosen? Are you chosen? If you are not chosen, you are not here. God has chosen. for what he has chosen, you need to know today. Because I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, this church will not be like this anymore. I'm not believing for it a dead or lukewarm church. There'll be people who are effective in the kingdom of God. I'm talking with full passion for the kingdom of God. None of you will be barren except you choose to be barren. You choose yourself to be barren, unfruitful, you may be one. But otherwise, according to the calling of God, none of you will be barren. You all will be fruit-bearing seeds of God. He has placed you with a purpose and plan. And the purpose is written here. We are excited to hear these words. You are a royal priest. I'm a king and a priest. We are excited with those words. But what we are not excited, what is this calling about? It says, a royal priest to the holy nation, his own special people, that you may, what? Proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. He called us from darkness. We all were in darkness at some time in our lives. Even if you're born in a Christian family, still you were in a darkness. Until the day you realize that Jesus Christ has called you to be his own. And you said, Lord, I'm accepting your call. I'm coming to you. I want to be in you. When you made the decision, you came out of darkness into his marvelous light. But why did he call you? He says, that you may proclaim the praises of him. One of the calling is that you may proclaim the praises of him in this dark world. You and as a church together, we all have to impact this dark world. It is a proactive work that we need to do, proactive decision that we have to make, and you have to do something more than what you're doing until today. You cannot be a normal churchgoer and come here and go back and live your rest of your week as you want. Or you cannot be a passive Bible reader. God is not looking for someone who reads a chapter in the Bible every day. Or five chapters, even if you read five chapters a day, it does not mean make any difference. God is looking for those people who take the Bible, who are hungry to find something which is deeply embedded in his word. And they eat the food and the fruit of the Spirit and receive that eternal food into them and grow by the word of God and become fruitful in this world. That's the people God is looking for. When he said in Psalm 1 and verse 1 onwards, when he say, blessed are those. Can we have the Psalm 1 just quickly? Blessed are those is a man who walks not in the counsel of ungodly, nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. Again, next verse. But his delight is in the law. When you say word law in the Testament, the Old Testament, change it to the word of God. Oh, in the word of God, word of the Lord, and he in his law or in his word, he meditates day and night. What happens to that person who meditates in the word of God day and night? Why is asking us to meditate day and night in the word of God when Jesus answered the devil, man, and he said this, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. If you want to live, you need to eat that word that comes out of the mouth of God. You need to eat the word, my brothers, my sisters. You need to get it into your belly. That will produce fruit. Then it says next words, he shall be like a tree planted by the river of water that brings forth fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither. And whatever he does, he shall prosper. You all like to prosper. How many of you like to prosper? How many of you like to prosper? Come on, raise your hands. Accept it. How many of you like to prosper? Prosperity is not just money, but prosperity is in everything. In your health, in your family, in your peace, in your joy. prosperity comes, it has been planned for you. In your calling, prosperity is included. Joy is included. Fruitfulness is included. In your calling, you know, everything, all things are included. I was preaching in the Telugu church, the message, in your salvation. It's a package that contains everything for your life. In the same book of Peter, Second Peter, chapter 1, verse 3, I think. One verse or two. Can you give me that one? Quickly. Second Peter, chapter 1, verse 2. Yeah, okay. Okay, can verse 3. And his divine power has given to us. His divine power has given to us. Come on. His divine power has given to us. Come on, again. His divine power has given to us. For what? Pertaining to life and godliness. You don't have to strive for your godliness, your prayer life. You don't have to strive for your livelihood. There is something kept in this package that you received when you received Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. He called us to be perfect people. Now, do you think you may say, I cannot be perfect? And whenever I say this word, I remember Brother Anthony. He believes we can be perfect. Amen. He may not be perfect, but he still believes. And I may not be perfect, I believe. And Jesus knows we cannot be perfect. But still he says, be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Is he asking us to do something that we cannot do? But he knows by which we'll become perfect. The Spirit of God whom he was going to pour upon us. He is perfecting us day after day. Hallelujah. You are not orphans. When I said this, you are not orphans. It includes this. You are not asked to do anything by yourself. The power has been poured from above upon you that you may prosper in his kingdom. And live a life of victory. Hallelujah. It is your personal decision, brothers and sisters. That's why I say, make sure your call. There is a call. In this calling, there are many things. You're called to prosper. You're called to be healthy. You're called to be joyful. But then you have to proclaim the praises of him who called you. You have to proclaim the praise of him who called you from darkness. If this dark world is looking for someone to bring the light into their lives. Do you have this responsibility? This morning, this is the question for you. In this calling, this is included. You have to bring this light, which is placed inside of you, to this dark world. Are you with me this morning? You know, God wants to raise you up, my brothers and sisters. I do not know. Some of you are going to be so stirred up this morning. You're going to rise up and you begin to do something. You'll start off something today onwards. Not tomorrow, but today onwards. God, I want to walk in the calling that you have for me. I want to do things that you have called me to do, Lord. Lord, I will not be barren. I'll be fruitful, Lord. I will see the fruit in me. You want to see fruit in me. But I want to see also, Lord, I want to be fruitful. Hallelujah. You are chosen people to bear fruit. Amen. You're chosen to bear fruit. The fruit, I want to tell you this understanding. Get this understanding. Jesus made you a seed. He actually sowed you as a seed into his kingdom. He has sowed you. You are a seed by yourself. Get this understanding. You are a seed. And I want to understand. Okay. Many of you will understand. Many seeds. When Jesus was giving the example of a mustard seed. But when it's a mustard seed, mustard plant, the plant that we know in India is a shrub. It only grows this high. But if you go to the internet and look for mustard tree, it's a tree in other places. It's a tree big enough. And Jesus was talking about that tree. And Jesus, when he is talking about this mustard seed, he says, a tree is coming out of this mustard seed. That whole tree has been put into this small little seed. The tree is already there in the seed. What you are going to become, it's already inside of you. You understand this? What you could be, the big tree, the powerful man and woman you would be, has been already kept enclosed in you. You need to let it come out. You need to let it come out of you. You should become a big tree and bear fruit. Hallelujah. You need to feed yourself that water, the precious water, Holy Ghost, and the water, the Word of God. And that Word and Holy Ghost will make you fruitful. You must feed on it. If you don't feed on it, nothing happens. As far as the seed is in your tin, in your house, nothing happens to it. Just take it out. Put them in the soil. One day, probably next day, maybe second day, third day, some trees take a long time. The coconut takes only 1 year to come out. A palm tree, an Indian palm tree, it takes about 3 months to sprout out. But there are some seeds, the next day they sprout. We don't know what seed you are. Maybe there are many coconut seeds here, which are taking only 1 year to sprout out. Doesn't matter. For some of you, the time is already lapsed. Your time has come today to understand. You need to sprout out and sprout out. And you let your root be deeper in the Word of God. And let your fruit come out. Let it flourish. Let's bring fruit. And that's what you need to be doing. Brothers and sisters, that is your calling. Your calling is to be fruitful, not to be barren, and bring glory unto your Lord. And this fruit must be enjoyed by the rest of the people in the world. This fruit, when it's eaten by others, they become fruitful as you are fruitful. The world is in darkness. When I prayed this morning in the beginning, and I would continue to do so every time I stand here to pray for the nations, because that is our responsibility to pray, because we can affect the things that are happening in this world by our prayer. When it said in 1 Timothy chapter 2, pray for the nation that you are living in. Pray for your leaders, those who are in authority, that you may live a peaceable life. That's what the Word of God says. Your prayer has effect. It can change the course of things that are happening in this world. Wars will be stopped by your prayer. National calamities can be stopped by your prayer. You know, the wickedness of this world can be brought into control by your prayer. Your prayer has power because God already put that power inside of you. When you pray, you do not pray dry words. You pray the Word of God, which has been deposited inside of you. Hallelujah. We had a wonderful time of prayer yesterday. We prayed the prayer of the Spirit. That's why it said pray in the Spirit. Romans 8:26, it says, when you do not know how to pray according to the will of God, but when you pray in the Spirit, when Holy Spirit comes upon you, when he brings the prayer words out of your mouth, you are praying things that you do not know, but you are praying for saints, you are praying for something unknown, and it begins to take place, and something begins to happen in some country, some faraway place, maybe 1,000 miles, 5,000 miles, something is sprouting out, something is changing. Some people are getting changed. Some people are getting born again because you're praying in the Spirit. You don't know what you're praying, but you're praying the will of God. Hallelujah. God has called you with a purpose. Make sure your call, if you make sure, what it says, be diligent. What the Word says, be diligent, put extra effort, all the effort that you have to understand your calling. See, I know most of you are putting a lot of effort to prosper in your workplaces, to get your promotions, to get appreciation in your workplace. Some children, they spend a lot of time studying to get good marks and so on. What are we doing together to prosper in the kingdom of God? Prosperity is promise, but that comes with few conditions. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, talks again about that matter. It says, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Meditate upon the word of God. There's a verse, I don't remember the scriptures in the book of Isaiah. It says, draw from the deep wells. Draw from the deep wells the living water. The word of God. The word of God is like water in the deep wells, where you need to put some effort. Take your buckets and, you know, tie a rope and put them down and draw them from there. Then you'll get that sweet, fresh water to drink. You need to put some effort, brothers and sisters, to make sure you're calling. I want to read a few scriptures concerning calling, and we'll go forward from that there. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Book of Romans. Quickly, I'll read it quickly. Romans 11:29 says, 11:29. For the gift and the calling of God are irrevocable. It will not be taken back. It has been given to you. The calling, your calling stays upon you. I'm not talking today to you about the specific callings that we all have. We all have specific callings in the kingdom of God, but we also have a general calling to proclaim the glory of God into this world in every possible way. Our life, it should shine in this world. Our very conduct among people. See, I want to tell you, Christians have brought shame to our God more in this world because they could not shine. You know, I want to tell you one thing told by one of our second president of India. He said, don't worry about these Christians. If they really follow what Jesus says, no one can stop them. They'll prosper. But most of the times, they don't do it, so we don't have to worry about it. He was sarcastic about it. But he said, if they do what they're saying, no one can stop them. But don't worry, they are not doing it. That's what's been happening in India. That's happened. If we could follow what our we call the father of India called Mahatma Gandhi, he followed the principles given by Jesus Christ, what he taught on the Mount, on the Sermon in the Mount. He followed the principle and got independence to our country. Yes. Everything he learned, he worked, he read it and said, I must follow this. And he followed it peacefully. He could bring. Of course, there are others who fought the fight in various other places. But then he followed this principle and he effected the British kingdom. In a way, they don't know what to do. They come to kill them and they stand quietly, do nothing. He frustrated them by following the principles given by Jesus Christ, and India got its independence. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Today, brothers and sisters, if you know the word of God and follow, try to follow it in your workplaces, you'll be victorious. That's why it says, meditate upon the word of God. I personally have an example. My own example in my workplace, a man used to always impersonate me. I was the in charge of the department. He would go behind me. I know I'm the in charge. He will tell, try to get some, even to the point they will get some bribes from some people. I will get to this order. They will get to this order. All these things is to do. And some people came and told me, he's doing this. You have to take action on this. I said, I'm praying my God will take care of my matter. I trusted the Lord. I prayed for this man. I did not pray that God should take him away. I said, pray, Lord, give him understanding. Lord, bless him. He's looking for some blessing. Bless him so that he will not do these things. But God, in turn, took him away from that place. In a few months' time, he was taken away. Totally. We don't have transfers in our department because we only one department in the whole of UAE, in Ministry of Health. There were no transfers. But he was transferred to another hospital, even though there was no department. He was forced out of this department. When you stand according to the word of God will work for you. The word of God will work for you. That's the reason it said, meditate upon the word of God and live by it. You'll prosper. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And about that, what I want to bring to you this morning is, I want to stir up all of you to take a stand. Tell yourself, how am I going to shine in this world for Jesus? That's what I want to call you today, to take some stand, make some decision this morning. I want to shine for Jesus in this land, in this world, not only in this land, all over the world. You need to fulfill the commandment of Lord Jesus Christ. When he said in Matthew chapter 28 verse 19, go into all world, preach the gospel. But the problem we still have is, we had a prayer yesterday. Sister Sudha was telling, claim our inheritance. Claim our inheritance. You know, we don't even ever think of our inheritance in this world. We don't even think about it. Do you know you have inheritance? Do you know? Come on, tell me, brothers and sisters. Do you know you have inheritance that you need to claim in this world? Everything. Psalms 24 verse 1. What it says. Get this understanding. The earth is the Lord's and all that is. All its fullness. The world and those who dwell therein belongs to whom? And Book of John chapter 1 verse 12 says, and everyone who believed in him, he gave them power to become children of God. Who are you? Who are you? Child, a singular. It's better to speak. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. If you are a child, you are not a slave. If you are a child, you are not a slave. If you are a child, you have inheritance in God's, not only kingdom, all that he possesses. What does the word say? All the people, all that is on earth belongs to our Father in heaven. You need to claim inheritance in this. You must show your possession. Your possession must be seen by you, at least in the spiritual realm. Is there something? I want to tell you one more thing. There's a time going to come, a rewarding time comes. You know, at the end, the word of God in the book of Revelation chapter 22, towards the last, I think verse 7 or somewhere, Jesus is coming soon and he comes with his rewards. Is anything that you have done to receive your reward? Reward is given for those. What is a reward? Is reward is not a gift, right? Is reward a gift? Reward is not a gift. Reward is paid to against something that you have done. Your salary is a reward for what you have done. And the word of God says, when Jesus comes at the end, he will come with his rewards. Did you do something? I mean, this is a question for you. You may be saying, I'm fasting, I'm praying, I'm doing so many things, so I'll get reward. Your reward will be according to what you have done. What you have done. So, what you have done has to be determined in your own heart. Is anything that you have done that affects this world? Does your behavior, your natural behavior, affect someone who's next to you? Is this affecting adversely or for better? You made somebody to change their lives, or you made their life worse because you have been treating them so bad. All this matters. God, Jesus put his light. When he said, you are the light of the world. Matthew chapter 5:14, he said, you are the light of the world. You need to bring that light into this world. As he said, do not put this light under a basket. Let it be kept on the lampstand. Are you keeping? I want to ask you this question. Are you keeping the light on the lampstand? Question yourself. Let you be stirred up this morning. I want to tell you, we are entering the new year, and this church, this congregation will not be the same in the days to come. I'm not believing for such a congregation. I'm believing for a congregation that is vibrant, that is dynamic, always working, going, running for souls. And this place should not be enough. This big place looked like it was growing, and suddenly we see nothing. You know, when you become light to somebody, everyone are attracted to the light. The word of God says in the book of Isaiah chapter 60, you see, you have, come, let's see that. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1 onwards, when we see. See, arise and shine. For your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Next verse. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth. Now, you understand what's covering the whole earth. The whole earth. You know, the problems, the troubles, the situations, the natural calamities, the wars, all those things. The whole earth is covered. But then what it says, and deep darkness, the people, but the Lord will arise over you. This morning, the Lord is risen over you by his word to change you, to transform you, to make you understand that you are powerful children of God. You are not somebody who is in darkness. You are not hopeless. You are not powerless. You're full of his power. You're called to be. And it says, but the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. Next verse. And this is, the Gentiles, those who are in darkness, shall come to your light. You have something that Gentiles could come to you. Well, who is Gentiles? Gentiles, everyone who do not know God as their personal Savior. Who are not saved. Everyone who is not saved is a Gentile. Everyone. Not as the Jewish people think. They think anyone other than Jewish people are Gentiles. But today, anyone who do not know God, who is not of God, is Gentile. And they are looking for this bright light which is in you. Brothers and sisters, can you shine? Can you shine? And it's a Gentile shall come to your light, and the kings to the brightness of your rising. Kings, rulers, big people. You know, brothers, I do not know, some of you will be witnessing to some great people. Some of you, I don't know who, but somebody, some of you may be very quiet, but you may be witnessing to some higher people, some rulers, some who are in authority. You'll witness and you'll bring them to the knowledge of the salvation of Lord Jesus Christ. You must believe that, and that will happen in your life. You must believe for extraordinary things. You must believe for unusual things, unusual experience in your day-to-day life, brothers and sisters. God has called you. God has a purpose in your life. And the next verse, verse 4, it says, lift up your eyes all around and see, they all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from afar, and your daughters shall be nursed at your side. What it tells, they all will come to you. And for the next verse, it says, furthermore, just look at that next verse. And it says, then you shall see and become radiant, and your heart shall swell up with joy, because the abundance of the sea shall be turned to you. The wealth of the Gentiles shall come to you. When you have the light, when you radiate the light into the dark world, where there is, you know, in the dark places, there is wealth, there is joy, there's peace that has been buried and kept. These people are holding it. They were sitting on it. They have to release it and bring it to the light, because they are looking for light. Are you understanding? You can't keep complaining. I'm not getting my promotion. I'm not getting my this thing. Oh, I'm not actually regarded for the work that I'm doing. Everything is in the seed. Your package in yourself. You are the seed. The package is there. It needs to come out of you. Wisdom is in you. Miracle working power is in you. Miracles are not happening because you don't do it. You agree with that? When Peter and John, after they received Holy Ghost upon them, they walked together to the temple, and they come to the gate called Beautiful. And there was a man sitting there, crippled for many years. They could have seen, oh, he needs some money. Let me take out some money and give and walk away. That's what they could do, right? We all do this. We see many beggars in India. We give money to them. But these people did not say. They stopped and said, look at us. And the man thought he will get some money. He said, silver and gold we have none. But we have much more powerful thing in us. That is the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Now come on, give your hand and rise up and walk. Hallelujah. And that's the same power is in you, my brother, my sister. The same power is in you. Can you take a step forward today? Make up your mind today. Can you take a step forward? I see one, I have a Facebook friend. I'm amazed to see this man. Every day he will put somebody he will be talking to. And he makes a picture of it and puts it in the Facebook. He does some kind of ministry. And he will be talking to people we cannot think of. He'll go and speak to those sadhus. You know, sadhu means sages, what you sage. Those people in India, we have those orange saffron dresses and long beards. If they're there, he'll go and talk to them, give them the gospel and tell them, make them say the prayer of sinner's prayer. And he also takes the documents, puts a picture. Then he goes to anybody, whether it's a Muslim or any name, and maybe a beggar. Maybe we, in India, we have many kinds of tribal people. They come to your home for begging and so on. He makes it a point to share with them. And he puts in my, I see, I don't know this person personally. Somewhere I got in touch, I mean, he's my friend kind of a thing. I wanted to talk to him. Last time I thought when I go to Hyderabad, I'll somehow get in touch with this man and talk to him. How do you do this? How do you do this? Because he's just like you and me. How he goes and talks to them, sits with them. He sits with them, actually sits wherever they are, under a tree. Maybe a beggar is begging on the roadside. He actually goes, sits with them and talks to them about Lord Jesus Christ. Everyone who's suffering is willing to listen to your story. Everyone who's suffering will listen to your story of your salvation. How you have come out, he will listen and he will be saved. There are many such people. Look at Jesus Christ himself on the day when he was thirsty at the well. When this Samaritan woman comes, he asks, can you give me some water? Even though he was not supposed to ask a Samaritan woman, he began a conversation with her. Gives her the gospel. Not only he won that woman alone, he made her an evangelist on the spot. She goes back to the village and brings the whole village with her to see Jesus Christ so Jesus Christ could preach to her. We preached to the whole village. He went and in fact stayed in that village for a couple of days. That's how you have to do some conversation with people and win people for the kingdom of God. This morning, there's a calling on your life. There's a power in you to fulfill your calling. When Jesus said in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you'll receive power. Then you will be my witnesses. You cannot be his witnesses without the power of God. Power has been invested in you today. Are you ready to do something? Will you be wanting to be effective in this world? Can we close our eyes this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father God. I will be sad if some of you did not make a clear choice to understand his or her calling and diligently, if you do not seek to know your calling, you will not know there is a calling upon your life, my brother, my sister. Not only I will be sad, but the Lord himself will be sad because he sent this word to you that you may be changed and be transformed. More than I and the Lord being sad, you will be sad for not making this choice today because you will not enjoy the prosperity, joy and peace which God kept for those who will do his work. There is a reward that is coming for those who does the work of God. Those who will claim inheritance, that inheritance will become theirs. You need to claim in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. There are people, souls waiting for you in this world. Thank you, Jesus. Likaraba. You need to do something. This morning, one thing that you have to do is, I need to do something. I want to be effective. I want to fulfill my call. I want to walk in the way that God wants me to walk. I want to be effective in this world. This year cannot pass away. The year was, a promise was given to me. An year of open doors and expansion. Open doors did come to you, but you did not walk through those doors out of the place. Expansion possibilities came to you, but you did not expand. You always thought open doors is only for your jobs and your prosperity and your money. Maybe only those things you thought. You never thought about the kingdom of God. This morning, there's a challenge coming in your way. Will you take this challenge? Even in the last few days, those open doors which were open for you to give gospel, will you do it? Will you do it? Will you do it? The Lord is asking, will you go through the doors which are open before you and expand the kingdom of God? Will you be that man, that woman God is calling you to be this morning? The power of God is moving. I want you to be stirred up in your heart by the power of the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost is moving in this place. There is something happening in your heart. Some of you are stirred up. Some great men and women of God are coming up. I am looking for people who will become great men and women of God. If God calls you to have a church, you can have a church. God calls you to have some ministry, you must have it. God is calling you. God has put that enough in your heart, and God will open those doors for you. God will lift you up from where you're sitting, my brother. You will not sit anymore. You will walk. You will run for the Lord. 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 The presence of God is touching some of you, transforming some of you, lifting up some of you. Come on, rise up. Don't sit anymore. If you feel like getting up and jumping, do it and say, Lord, here am I. Here am I, Lord. I will serve you with my whole heart. Come on, get up now. This is your chance to say, tell, speak to the Lord. Stand up to your feet and begin to speak to Him. Tell, Lord, here am I. I will serve you. I'll be effective in this kingdom. Oh, in your kingdom, I'll bring transformation in this world. Oh, I will not be in darkness anymore. I am the light of the world. I will lit up this world. Lord, we'll see glory, glory, your glory, Master God. Uri mara shiri ando kuraba. Or yara mari ando nimeshi baru thokuru na masaba. Reketo ro nimeshi andra baha. Likre tre bashara bashima. Or yine kere bishandri kera ba. Rimashia. Or begin to accept to the Lord. Tell Lord, here am I, Lord. Use me. Do something with me. Do what you want for me, Lord. I am willing, Lord. I will go, Lord. I will go, Lord. Oriyara Mashandaba. I will do, Lord. I will go, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oriya Bashandrabaha Saba. Riketo Korabrashabaha. Oh, here am I, Lord. Oh, here am I, Lord, Father God. Here am I, Lord, Master God. Oriba Sharabrasaba. Oh, Master God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, it's a prayer. Ori Marashananda Kalabasab. And as the Spirit of God moves, make some choices, Lord. Look, brothers and sisters, God is moving you. God is stirring up you to be the powerful people in this world. Ori Arabashandra Kuri Hirashaba. Ori Andakira Maranamashakra. Ori Marashaba. God is pleased with those who said, Lord, whatever it takes, I will be and I will do something to affect this world, Lord. It can begin with your prayers, my brothers and sisters. And your prayers followed by an action. Exercising the faith that has been put inside of you already. A measure of faith has been implanted into you.
That little faith, faith like a mustard seed, let that mustard seed sprout inside of you. Water it with word and the Spirit of God. And that faith will grow up. It will spread around. You'll do such things, such exploits for the kingdom of God, which you never thought you would do. You may be a person who's so quiet, sits in the back, but God will put word of God in the mouth. You will speak it. Some will be affected because you said something. Prophets are rising in this house. Prophets. God, those who see visions are rising in this house. I see in the spirit. They will come up. People will not be shy anymore. Shyness is taken away from you. You will not fear anymore. You will rise up to speak because you are stirred up in your spirit by the Spirit of God. Preachers, evangelists are coming out from this church. There are evangelists sitting very quietly in this house. Oh, powerful evangelists who do signs and wonders are sitting in the house. Today they are stirred up. That seed has been stirred up to bring forth fruit. Evangelists. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Some women. From your house, you will do evangelism. Sisters who are sitting, who are working, being as housewives in your own house, you may be thinking, what will we do? From your house, you'll be evangelizing to people. Sometimes to your neighbors, sometimes over the phone. You will evangelize. Your prayers will affect some people in a faraway place, and they will turn to the Lord. Roman Shadi Kira Varuna Masala. Nikito Roso Kuru Di Birdo Bashamba. Urialandara Namashaba. Oh Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, we thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, we thank you for your presence. Father, we thank you for your word, oh Father God. You have stirred up people, Lord, Master God. You have chosen people here, Father God. People began to look into their calling, Lord, Master God. Make them understand the calling. For whatever purpose you're called, they all will walk in that calling, Lord. They will rise up to be powerful men and women of God, Father God. They will not be shy anymore. They will not quietly in the corner. Lord, they'll prophesy when you must strengthen them. They'll evangelize when you show them a person. They'll pray for the sick. Sick will be healed. And there will be miracles, signs, and wonders in their own personal life of Father God. They'll prosper to the next level of Father God. We give you glory, Lord, and honor and praise, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for coming and blessing us, Lord. In Jesus' most precious name we pray, Lord.